it's important to build a relationship with the students and with the parents. I call each one by name in the morning when they get on, I call them by name. Each afternoon when they get off, I call them by name. You have patience to be with students. It's a very rewarding job. You know, I wish that I'd started earlier than I did, but now that I've got 19 years in, I look back and I think, man, it's been great. They all have been a blessing in my life.
I just enjoy working with the kids and seeing them every day and making them smile and, you know, being a part of their day. You get to maybe change somebody's life. It makes me feel good because, you know, maybe not, I'm the reason they want to come to school sometimes, that they get that meal and they're able to focus on school better.
I love working with the students. As an instructional assistant, I think one of the most rewarding things is you get more one-on-one time with the students. One of my favorite stories was a fifth grade boy that I was working with all year. He had never completed one book, and we started reading this one book. And the last day of school, all these kids were out there playing and doing their field day activities, and he came up to me and he said, "Miss Miller, can we please finish that book? I don't want to graduate from Lakewood and not ever have finished reading a book." And he did. And to this day, we still keep track of each other. And I think he's a junior in high school now, and he's doing really well.
Saw a job opening for a custodian at North Hardin High School and applied there, and been with Hardin County Schools ever since. Came from the high school to the elementary, Meadowview Elementary, and when I'm sitting in the lobby, this girl had come down from one of the ramps and she had pigtails. She was probably first grade and her front teeth were missing, and she smiled and waved at me, and I thought, wow, I'm gonna love working here. The kids, always a smile on their face, always nice, always just really brighten your day. And I really don't have any complaints about my job. I love my job. I love working for Hardin County Schools. Probably one of the best jobs I've ever had, actually.
I live in Jefferson County. I am driving 35 minutes to come to Lincoln Trail. I did teach in Jefferson County 1 year. I just decided that Hardin County was a better fit, fell in love my first year, and just decided to stay in Hardin County School District. Just seeing that moment, that aha moment, when they click, it's like, oh my gosh, you got it. And it's like, wow, I love it. Teachers here do whatever it takes to help each kid. So, and I love that.
Of course, I've been here at Meadowview my whole 25 years. Most of the time it's successes, whether it's with a relationship and a child coming a far long way with just their confidence, or if they've come a long way academically. So it's very rewarding. And you see highlights every single day.
I'm a substitute teacher, but I'm in school to be an elementary teacher. So 7 kind of worked out with my schedule better. I've always loved working with kids. I feel like that's just my passion, is working with kids, from coaching to teaching. I just feel like I can have a huge impact on, you know, just kids' lives and their future. Well, I chose Hardin County because I went to school. I went to Central and East Hardin, and I just love it. I love all the people. You know, I know people at pretty much every school in the district. And I love the environment. Every school I've been to is amazing. The people are friendly and accepting, and I just love the environment of it.
It was just a miraculous decision. I did not realize it was going to be my calling, that I have just grown to absolutely love it. Just to show them the love, that we care, we are here for them no matter what the situation is, just to help them grow. You just don't want to miss a day in their lives.
Being a self-employed realtor, finding healthcare coverage was a really difficult thing, especially affordable healthcare coverage. And that's why I started doing the bus driving. Being around the kids, being in the school atmosphere, getting to interact with them is a real joy to me.
I see potential in kids, and I want to help them reach that potential. I love this school. The community that I feel here with my colleagues and the students that I get to work with every day, I think that we have a momentum going, and it's growing to really build a positive culture here and to have a sense of community and to be proud. That to me is exciting, and it adds the fun into why you become a teacher. I think that teachers are excited to be a part of a district that does that for its students, and I think it excites students.
I went into the teaching profession because I knew I was going to make a difference in kids' lives, knowing that every morning when I come into work, my kids are going to hug me, and when they leave at the end of the day, they're going to say, "I don't want to leave," and that's why I teach. I think the biggest thing that I learned growing up was building family relationships, especially in a school like this where there are so many different family dynamics. It's so important to know your kids and know what they need, you know, what they might be going through at home. I'm going to be here for them every day, I think, is is comforting for them.
When I retired, I couldn't sit around the house. I decided I became a driver. January the 13th of this past year. Well, I'm a diabetic. I lost my leg. State of Kentucky, I cannot drive a school bus. They take care of you. They offered me a job. They said, why don't you be a monitor? I said, I'd love to be a monitor. As soon as they came out of school, saw me, they hollered at me, Mr. Lark, Mr. Lark, and they came running up and hugging me. That makes you feel great. You've made a difference. Probably in some of them's lives, you made a big difference.
I taught at the biggest district in Atlanta, and I love it here because it's smaller. Everybody knows everybody. I feel like it's a family. My purpose is to serve my community, and it means so much to me because I'm from Radcliffe. Yesterday was a moment for me. A student had a breakdown. You know, he was in a ball. He was really upset. I told him to put his arms up. I said, I love you. I'm not mad at you, because he called me a couple names before I got to him. And he just put his arms around my neck, and he would not let go. I rode the bus with him the whole ride home. I just felt everything he was feeling put on me, and that just really solidified why I'm here. Every kid in this school is our kid. If they are in this school, they're our kid.
When I first started working, I was 58, and my kid said, Mom, nobody's gonna hire you because you don't have experience. I said, I've raised 5 kids and 72 foster kids. I said, I think I qualify. You can come in here with a sad face and you look at them children and they just like make you smile. All the teachers, my coworkers, they're great. You know, and the kids will say, you're gonna retire and enjoy your life. I said, I'm enjoying my life right now. And I've already told Miss Carrie I was staying until I was 75. You know, you gotta love your job, and I do, I can't help it.